Dear children, today we are going to learn under the topic that is money, we are going to learn the unitary method. Okay, today the topic is unitary method. What is meant by unitary method? That is, we have to calculate the value of each item. Okay, from the value of few items, we are going to calculate the cost of value of one item. Okay, let me see with example sum. Today we move on to the topic, that is unitary method. Okay, our topic is money and subtopic is, that is unitary method. Okay, to calculate the value of, or to calculate the cost value, that is cost of each item from the value of given items. Okay, I am going to write one question and we are going to let me know the concept of unitary method with example sum. Okay, I am going to write the question, that is cost of, that is a dozen pencil is equal to, that is 96 rupees. Okay, if it is a dozen, cost of a dozen material is given and we are going to find out the value of each item. Okay, let me see, that is cost of, this is our question, that is cost of a dozen, okay, cost of a dozen pencils, okay, that is rupees 96. Okay, find the cost of, okay, the question is find the cost of 3 pencils. Okay, this is the question. So cost of a dozen pencils, that is rupees 96. Okay, find the cost of 3 pencils. So first we have to calculate to find out the cost of each pencil, so that only we have to calculate the cost of 3 pencils. Okay, so let me first calculate each pencil cost. You have to, that is divide, okay, this is a divide sum, that is a dozen means a dozen is equal to number of 12. Okay, you know the term, that is a dozen means the number that is equal to that of 12. Okay, so here that is cost of 12 pencil, that is a dozen means dozen is equal to 12. Okay, dozen means that is 12. Okay, so here cost of 12 pencils rupees 96 is given. So find the cost of each pencil, that's a first step in this sum. Okay, let me do, that is cost of 12 pencils is equal to rupees 96. Okay, so we have to find out the cost of each pencil, that is cost of 12 pencils is equal to 96. So cost of each pencil, okay, cost of each pencil, you have to divide, that is that 96 divided by 12 to find the cost of each pencil. Okay, so let me divide the number, that is 96 divided by 12. Say the 12 table, children. Okay, that is 112. You have to, you should memorize the multiplication table, that is in your, that's answer is in your fingertip. That's only you are doing all the manipulation of multiplication and division sums. Okay, so that is 5 12s are 60, 6 12s are, okay, goes on, and 8 12s, okay, that means 8 12s are 96. Okay, so put a quotient here, 8 12s are 96, that is answer is 0. So answer is quotient, that is 8. So that is now cost of each pencil. Okay, this is the answer. That is cost of each pencil. That is rupees 8. Okay, so find the cost of each pencil. Now find the cost of 3 pencils means that is cost of each pencil, that is 8. So then we have to find the cost of 3 pencil. We have to multiply the answer. That is a concept that is to find out the cost of many means you have to multiply. Okay, and cost of, find the cost of each item or each material means you have to divide the number. So okay, so that is here we find out the cost of each pencil. Now we are going to find out the cost of 3 pencils. Okay, that is cost of each pencil. So I'm going to follow this sum to find out the cost of 3 pencils. So therefore cost of 3 pencils, okay, that is 8 into 3. Okay, that means 8 threes are 24. So this is a cost of 3 pencils. So this is a 24 rupees. This is a final answer. And cost of 3 pencils. Okay, so do you understand, children? That is cost of each. That is a unitary method to find the value of each item or each product. Okay, and let me do one more sum for this method for easy understanding. Okay, let me do next sum to calculate same this unitary method. I'm going to write another example sum. Okay, let me do, that is second one, second example sum. Okay, that is Mr. Okay, any name, that is Mr. Kareem or okay, Mr. Kareem earned, okay, earned rupees, okay, 64,000, okay, in 2 months. In 2 months. Okay, so it's a person, he is a person, Mr. Kareem earned rupees 64,000 in 2 months. Okay, and find the earning of Mr. Kareem in a year. Okay, so that is Mr. Kareem earned rupees 64,000 in 2 months. Okay, in 2 months. And find the earning of Mr. Kareem in a year. Okay, so you have to first observe the question and to know what is to be find out, and to observe and to understand the concept. Okay, so read the question twice or thrice, children. Okay, and here that is 2 months. Okay, earning of Mr. Kareem, that is 2 months, that is 64,000. So you have to divide the 64,000 by 2 to find his each month earning. Do you understand? Okay, that's the earning of 2 months of Mr. Kareem is given. The amount is 64,000. Okay, so you have to calculate the earning of each month. So first you have to divide this 64,000 by 2, because this is a earning, that is a pay salary of that person for 2 months is equal to 64,000. Okay, so that is you are going to write the word problem statement, that is earning of 2 months is equal to, that is 64,000, and divided by, okay, earning of 2 months. Okay, and here the earning is given by 2 months. Okay, so divided by 2, so that only we have to get the salary earning of each month. Okay, so that is 64 divided by 2. That is, you are going to divide the number. That is 3 2s are 6. Okay, minus 0 and put down this 4. And 2 2s are 4. And remaining 3 0. Okay, that is going to be put as a quotient because it goes on only with 0. So the quotient is, that is 64 divided by 2. So the quotient is 32,000. Okay, that 32,000 is the earning of each month. Okay, so here earning of each month, okay, rupees, that is 32,000. Rupees 32,000. Once 10 center put comma, that is 32,000. Okay, so this is earning of each month. Okay, we found out the value of each month. And next the question, that is find the earning of Mr. Kareem in a year. Okay, how to calculate this for year? That means each year, that is we have already discussed the time topic. Okay, already we learned and discussed the time topic in our previous video. Okay, that is 1 year is equal to, that is 12 months. Okay, do you remember that? 1 year is equal to 12 months. So, in a year means you have to multiply this 32,000 into, that is 12. Okay, do you understand now? Find the each value by 2. And now we are going to find out the year. So, in a year means 1 year. That 1 year is equal to 12 months. So, you have to calculate the this amount. That is 1 year is equal to 12 months. Okay. And therefore, okay, therefore, calculate the year. Earning of year. Earning of a year is equal to 32,000 into 12. Okay. And in our multiplication topic, we have discussed the zero ending number that we are going to multiply, that is 2 digit with 2 digit, and put the zero to the right side of the product. That's a method. Okay, we have discussed in our multiplication topic. Okay, that is a multiplication video. We learn the number that ends zero ending number, how to multiply means here is a 2 digit and this is also 2 digit. So simply multiplying 32 into 12 and put 3. How many zeros are here, children? That is 3. So put the 3 zero to the right side of the product. So that will be very easy to multiply the big number. So this is a technique to find out the answer in short way, how to multiply the zero ending number in our previous topic, that is multiplication topic, that we already, that is we have discussed the zero ending number in multiplication. Okay, let me recollect. And that is, you have to simply multiply 32 into 12 and put the zero to the right side of the product. Okay, for multiplication 32 and 12. Okay, that is 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Okay, and that is 1 2 is 2, 1 3 is 3. And simply adding the number 4, 6 plus 2, 8 and 3. That's answer is 384. Okay, 384. And add, put the 0 to the right side of the product. This is the product. So put the 3 0 here. Okay, 1 tens 100, 1000, 10,000. Okay, 384. 1000 is the answer. That's the earning of Kareem in a year. Okay, this is the answer. That is Mr. Kareem's earning in a year. That is 384,000 rupees. Don't forget to put the unit of answer. Okay, that means this is our money topic. So answer will be whether it is must in the rupees and paise value only. Okay, so write the unit of the right side of the answer. If it is the money topic, so don't forget to put the answer with its units. Okay, so this is a method to calculate, that is the method of unitary method, to find out the cost of each one, and we will get back that is the answer from this each item cost, find out the final answer. Okay, so I hope you can understand this. Okay, and let me move on to the next topic, that is measurement, in our next session. Okay.